I mean, this time of year, as you're absolutely right, the birds are hungry. Mm. They, small little birds you see out in the garden, they need to eat sometimes up to a third of their body weight every single day. Can you imagine how many potatoes that would be? I mean, it is a really enormous amount of work that goes into it. So these real energy-rich foods, which the kids are putting together here, can be really vital. And this is a fantastic time because the trees have lost their leaves, the birds coming into the garden, you can see them more, and you can attract them to where you can actually view them. So what we've got here...
So what's Toby making?
Toby is making... Hello. ..the peanut butter log. So what have you been mixing with here with this? You've got...
Well, I've had the peanut... I've got the peanut butter and I've got the seeds. I poured the seeds into here and now I need to put them into the holes for the birds.
So, what's the idea behind this? So drilled holes in there.
Drilled holes into sticks. It doesn't need to be this big. You can dangle them from a tree after you've done it. But it creates a structure on which the birds can perch and they can then be pecking away at the really energy-rich peanut butter and seeds.
So, Toby's filling the hole there.
So, which
you
is...
just squish it in with your finger, Toby, do you? It's a nice, messy job.
Oh, it's fantastic. Yeah. It really, really is getting messy.
Do the birds perceive this as grubs or worms or what?
Well, they're looking for energy-rich food. So a lot of these birds will eat nuts, they will eat these things. They are going to be continually bouncing around your garden looking for things which are potentially food. They'll be attracted by the smell, they'll be attracted by the sight of the seeds. You've got these black seeds in there, the black sunflower seeds in there, which are going to attract them in. They're going to come and they're going to give it a go.
Zach is getting into a lovely mess over here. Yeah. What have you got in
there? Well, we've got lard and then we put, like, some sunflower seeds and... some seeds and some cranberries.
And all these seeds, I mean, are these particularly for birds, or these you can just use any sunflower
Specifically use bird seed, which you can get from most retailers will do this. But what we're doing with this, the pine cones act as a really good structure in which you can force the fat, and then you tie a string around it, you can dangle it from the trees. And
enjoying that, Zach?
I'm just so glad I'm not doing it. But it is a really good way of doing this. You can then end up putting these around your garden. One of the really important things is, you see, people think, feed the birds in your garden, put out a bird table, throw some food on it.
Yeah.
But what you're doing there is you're concentrating all of the birds in one place.
Uh-huh.
And then we do have in this country this really amazing and quite dangerous predator, the domestic cat. You're creating a feeding station for domestic cats.
Nowhere to go.
So what you do is you hang these around the garden and you'll be able to dilute the concentration of birds and you'll be able to give them a really energy-rich feast at this time of year.
So you're squishing all that in there and then you just hang that up.
Yeah. Use dried cones because they've already opened up. When they're damp, they're closed up, but this gives them much more structure.
Okay.